Hello, Pocoyo. It's good to see you.
Hi.
Where have you been these past weeks? Oh, I see. You've been on holidays. I bet you can't wait to tell your friends all about it. And here's Pato, also back from holidays too. How nice. You and Pocoyo will have plenty to talk about. And so will you, Ellie. Holidays are over for everyone. Time for a reunion. Home at last. Well, it's good to be together again. Ah, Ellie, very nice. And Sleepy Bird too. Well now, let's hear what you each did on your holidays. Who wants to start? Pato, perhaps? Oh, a trip to the beach. And you built a sandcastle there. Then you went fishing. What's that? The fish was bigger than that? Still not big enough? Now? Tremendous. Ah, you had some fun in the snow, Ellie. Let's hear all about it. You met some new friends. And you built a big snowman together. My, that is big. And you practiced jumps with your snowboard. How cool is that? What's that? The jump was higher? This high? You jumped so far, you even had time to read and do some yoga and even have a tea party. Why, that's unbelievable. And it looks like Pocoyo and Pato might agree with me. Okay, okay, Ellie. Let's hear your story, Pocoyo. You went flying to outer space. You flew past some amazing planets. A lettuce planet? Sounds very healthy. And a strawberry planet? Delicious. Until you got to a planet made of cake and giant candy? Are you quite sure, Pocoyo? You seem to have had a lot of fun there, Pocoyo. And then you ate the whole planet?
Yeah!
Well, did that really happen? I'm not sure the others buy your tale, Pocoyo. What about your holidays, Sleepy Bird? What did you do? That just might be the most wonderful holidays of all of them.
Mine best.
Hold on now. Must you all argue about your holidays? After all, it's fun to share our holiday stories with our friends. Even if maybe some parts of the stories aren't exactly how things happened.
No!
Come on now, Pocoyo. And really, the best part is that you're all here having fun together again. Off you go. Time for play.
Let's play!
And no more tall tales.
Bye-bye.
Good. Bye-bye now. Hello, Potto. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oh, the postman. And he's got a postcard. I wonder who it's from. It's Ellie. She's at the beach. What fun. It would be nice to go to the beach.
I make.
You'll make a beach, Pocoyo? Well, you'll need a spade.
Spade.
A bucket.
Bucket.
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses.
And a sandcastle.
Sandcastle.
Okay, let's make a beach.
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Potto says, this is a beach. And this is the sun. The sun. At the beach, you use an umbrella to block the sun. It's very nice under the umbrella. Baby Bird, it's your turn. Can you tell Baby Bird what that is?
Umbrella!
It's an umbrella.
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Umbrella!
Wonderful! Now we've all learned about the beach. Thank you, Professor Potto.
Lesson approved by Professor Potto.
Ah, it looks like you two are ready for the beach. Can you tell me what that is?
A spade!
That's right, a spade. And what's this?
It's a bucket!
Right, it's a bucket. But that's not all you need, boys. Can you tell me what those are?
Sunglasses!
Fantastic! You're ready for the beach. The postman again. Ah, another postcard. Ellie has a very big sandcastle. How are you going to make a sandcastle?
I find.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
A monkey!
A monkey! Monkey!
A monkey! Right! Ah, you found some sand! And what a beautiful sand castle!
Sand castle!
Ellie's back! Can you tell Ellie what Pocoyo and Pato did?
A beach!
They made a beach! Beach!
What's this? Shells! Seashells! Wonderful! So long! See you soon!
Let's go to the beach, let's play in the sun with our sunglasses on. Let's open the umbrella and play with the spade and the bucket. Let's make a sandcastle, yeah. Let's go to the beach, let's play in the sun with our sunglasses on. Let's open the umbrella and play with the spade and the bucket, yeah.
Hello, Ellie. Off to the beach, are you? Ah, just a quiet day by yourself. That sounds very relaxing. Why, look, there's Pato. Ellie, I think Pato wants to go with you. What's that, Pato? You wouldn't mind driving? That's very nice of you. What do you think, Ellie? Easy, Pato. Ellie was hoping for a relaxing day today. Ah, yes, much better. More friends, Ellie. Well, one more couldn't hurt, right, Ellie? And off we go, all together. What's the matter, Nina? Oh, of course. Pato, you'd better stop the car. You too, Pocoyo. Oh, great. Just what we needed. Which way to the beach?
There.
Ah, very good, Ellie. Maybe he can tell us how to get there. Back at the same place again. Oh no, not again. Finally, let the fun in the sun begin. Well, Ellie, there's nothing like sharing this marvelous sunset with your friends, is there? Even if it was a little hard to get to the beach. Goodbye, everyone. Oh my, a pirate flag? Our friends seem different. They have a telescope. Pocoyo has an eye patch.
A map!
And they have a map. Oh, I see. They're pirates.
Treasure chest!
They're pirates looking for a treasure chest. Oh, they're piranhas. Be careful, Pirate Pocoyo. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you.
Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to an island. He took a ship. But then, the ship started to sink. So he took a boat. But then the boat started to sink. So he started to swim. When he got to the island, he phoned his friend, the ant. He asked the ant to come to the island too. So the ant took a ship. But the ship started to sink. So the ant took a boat. But the boat started to sink. So the ant started to swim. When the ant got to the island, they made a lovely sandcastle and had lots of fun. The end. Our pirates are still looking for the treasure. I think Pato sees something. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato saw?
The treasure chest!
He saw the treasure chest!
Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato used to see the treasure chest?
The telescope!
He used the telescope!
What do you see, Pocoyo?
Treasure chest!
What is that? The treasure chest is guarded by a monster. How will our pirates ever get the treasure?
Wheel of Colors. Welcome to the show. Today's color is... orange. Everyone look for something orange. Something orange. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. An orange tent. An orange flag. An orange block. Good. Keep searching for orange things. A carrot. Yes, it's orange. An orange key. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is?
An orange alien.
An orange alien. Very good. Hooray for orange. Hooray! The pirates have landed! Oh, the piranhas are coming too! Uh-oh!
Treasure chest!
Oh no! The monster is awake! Run, Pocoyo, run! And the piranhas! Run, Pato! Run! Oh, dear. Phew! Now, open the treasure chest. Oh! Can you tell me what that is?
A map!
It's another map.
Another treasure hunt! Ahoy, Pocoyo!
Pirates. We have a map and a telescope. We are the great little pirates. We're sailing the sea with our pirate flag. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest, looking through that telescope.
Treasure chest!
We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest, looking through that telescope.
Meow, meow.
Phew. Hi, Pardo. Whew. It certainly is a hot summer day. That's it, Pocoyo. Maybe it would be better just to go someplace cool, like the mountains.
The mountains.
Pato, I think you're the best choice to lead the expedition. Besides, you've certainly come very well prepared. Top at last. How wonderful. Wow. Pato, there you are. Finally. Better set up your tent. Like Pocoyo and Nina. Oh, you found the tent poles. But those are golf clubs. I'm afraid you took the wrong bag, Pato. Don't worry. I'm sure Pocoyo and Nina will lend you a hand. Look, Pato, a gift for you. Isn't it magical? What a wonderful camping trip this is, after all. Good night, everyone. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Sorry. Hello. What are you doing in that boat?
Fish.
Ah, I see. You're fishing.
Net.
You have a fishing net and a fishing rod. And Caterpillar is going to help. Wonderful. Now we just have to wait.
Professor Toto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a ship. A ship. This is a boat. A boat. And this is a lighthouse. A lighthouse. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell baby bird what that is?
It's a lighthouse!
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Lighthouse!
Wonderful! Now we know about ships, boats and lighthouses. Thank you, Professor Pato!
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Can you tell Caterpillar what that is?
This is a fish!
That's right, it's a fish. Can you tell the fish what that is?
A net.
It's a fishing net.
Can you tell the fish what that is?
A fishing rod.
It's a fishing rod.
Look, boys. Pato's got something.
Pato, fish.
A boot? A wheel? Fishing can be very hard. Number menu! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 10 strawberries. Very good.
10 strawberries.
10 Well, how about 10 peas instead?
10 peas.
10 peas. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
10 hearts.
That's right. 10. Oh dear, you're not catching many fish. Oh, it's a big one! A very big one! Now, Pato and Pocoyo, you're not really angry, are you? After all, it was pretty funny. Hooray for fishing! And hooray for new friend!
I'm in a boat, I am fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net.
Using my net. Rod. Net. Fish. Ship. Boat. Lighthouse.
I'm in a boat. I am fishing with my fishing rod. Catch a fish, I am using my net.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Lovely day, isn't it? Pocoyo, the little alien wants to take your picture. Beautiful flowers, Pato. I think your garden has some admirers. Thank you. very lifelike. How's ballet practice going, Ellie? Yes, it's very important to stretch. It seems you have some new fans. We've seen a lot of little aliens today, haven't we? Uh-oh. They want to take a selfie with your sandwich. Look out, Nina! It's time for the green aliens to go home to their own planet. He says, thank you for everything. You say you all had a wonderful time? Well, that's great. Ellie says you are always welcome to visit again. But maybe not all at once next time.
Wait!
Oh, right! You want to give them a snack for the trip home. Very nice, Pocoyo. Bye-bye, everyone.
Dirty. Oh, my. It certainly is a hot day here in Pocoyo's world.
Oh, and look, there's Ellie. Looks like she's trying to keep cool.
Hello, Ellie. You haven't seen Pocoyo today, have you, Ellie? That's strange. He usually enjoys the heat on a hot day.
I know. Maybe he's with Pato. I'll see you, Ellie.
Ah, and there's Pato. I believe Pato is trying to keep cool, too. Pato, you haven't seen Pocoyo, have you? Pato, but was that a no or a... sorry, Pato, I still didn't quite catch that. Are you saying...
All right. I'll keep looking then.
Sorry to have disturbed you, Pato. Now, I wonder where Pocoyo could be. Oh, there you are at last. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula.
Hi.
And look, it's Pocoyo's musical flower.
Flower. Music.
Pocoyo just loves his musical flower. Did you know, I believe Pocoyo has the only musical flower in the whole world. Looks like it's empty, Pocoyo.
More music.
Yes, it would be nice to hear more music, wouldn't it? How can you get your flower to play more music if your watering can is empty, Pocoyo? Can any of you help, Pocoyo?
Get more water!
More water!
It seems the water tap has dried up in all this heat as well. At least you've filled up your watering can for your flower.
Flower.
Poor Pato must be terribly thirsty. Oh, Pocoyo, that's very nice of you, giving some of the water to Pato.
Flower!
Oh, I wonder what she's up to. Oh, now I see. Ellie's going to take a nice cool bath to beat the heat. What a good idea. There's nothing an elephant likes better than a nice cool bath. Oh dear, there's no water left. Oh, there goes Ellie's bath, and she was so looking forward to it. Oh, Pocoyo, what a good deed. You certainly made Ellie feel better. But shouldn't we see about your...
flower.
Oh, dear. It seems that Pocoyo used up all his water helping his friends. Now there's no water for his flower.
Don't worry, Pocoyo. Maybe someone will help you. I think someone might be on their way right now. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
I am
Pocoyo! Oh, well, that's very nice, but I think the flower needs more than... Look at that! It seems that when friends help each other, magical things can happen. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Little fish just waved at me. I will leave you be. I won't catch you, little fish. 8 and 9 and 10. Happy swimming in the sea. One and two and three. Walking on my foot so free. 4 and 5 and 6. A little ant just waved at me. I will leave you be. You go 8 and 9 and 10. Little ants, I love you so. 4 and 5 and 6. A little spider waved at me. I will leave you be. Spider, you will be all right. 8 and 9 and 10.
I will give you half the fight.
La 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 la. 1 and 2 and 3. All the creatures living free. 4 and 5 and 6. A fish and ant just waved at me. We will have some fun. And if the spider wants to come, 8 and 9 and 10. We'll have a great time, everyone.
We'll have a great time, everyone.
Hello, Pato. What a lovely day to care for your plants. Oh dear. Pato, it seems someone shut the water off. What was that? Pato. Pato, please slow down a bit. You say you saw a little green creature like this one? Thank you. Says her name is Nina. Why not introduce yourself, Pocoyo?
Pocoyo.
And this is Roberto. Hello, Nina and Roberto. It seems she's never shaken hands before. Pato. An umbrella? But it's not raining. So, you've seen Pato before. You were playing with your friend the ladybug, and Pato came. He watered the plant, and you got all wet. Oh, but Nina, I'm quite sure Pato didn't mean to get you wet. Pato was just watering his plants to help them grow. Yes, because he loves plants more than almost anything. She says that anyone who loves plants deserves a hug. Uh-huh. Oh, I see. That's to warn Nina whenever Pato waters the plants. Brilliant! This calls for a celebration. Roberto, would you?
Duck said, what? went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 but only one little duck came back. Over the hills and far away, Mother Duck said, quack, 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 quack. And all of the five little ducks came back.
Hello, everyone!
Hi!
My, what a beautiful garden! You have tomatoes, and lettuce, and what is that exactly?
Carrots!
Carrots, of course! It's a delicious-looking garden. Hi, Ellie.
Ellie. Search, Ellie.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Plant.
To plant. Ellie is searching for to plant. It's Pato. He is planting a seed. Wow! Fantastic!
Mar! Water!
Pocoyo would like you to search for to water. Look! Pato is watering his flowers.
Thank you, Ellie!
Yes, thank you, Ellie. Well done! What's that, Ellie? You say it's time to pick your vegetables? Ellie says you should pick the tomatoes first. Your tomatoes! They're gone! Look! Now the lettuce is moving! At least your carrots are still there. Oops! Follow the vegetables! Oh, dear.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is? a spider. Right.
Hello.
This is very strange. Can you tell me what this is?
It's lettuce!
And what is this?
Tomato!
It's a tomato!
And this?
It's a carrot!
That's right! It's a carrot! And it's moving! Look! It's an ant! It's a lot of ants! It seems our little friends didn't take your vegetables. They just wanted to make a salad for you. And what a delicious salad it is!
Like a very big seed. You know what you do with a seed, don't you, Pocoyo? What do all of you think? Is that what you do with a sieve? Wear it on your head?
No!
Put it in your drink. Is that right?
No!
You don't put it there.
Do you plant it?
Yes, you plant it.
That's right. I'm sure that before long something very beautiful will grow from that seed. It does seem to be taking its time, doesn't it? Well, growing can take a while, you know. What's that, Pocoyo? Is something the matter? Oh, I see you need the loo. Well, we'll keep an eye on the seed for you. Hurry! Hello, sleepy bird. It's a lovely seed, isn't it? Wait! But what are you doing? Feeling better now, Pocoyo? Good, because there's something I need to tell you. It's about your seed.
Sleepy bird!
It's all right, Pocoyo. Sleepy bird just fancied a snack. Everything's fine now. Oh, look, here's Lula. Hello, Lula. Oh, no! Pocoyo, wake up! Wake up! Oh, dear. Maybe if you shout with me, we can wake Pocoyo. Ready?
Wake up, Pocoyo!
Wake up! Oh, I see. Lula just wanted to play. Well, that should certainly keep your seed safe, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato. Oh, Pato, I know that looks like an egg, but really it's... Oh, dear. What's this? Well, I'd say your seed is going to be safe now, Pocoyo. No one could possibly get it. Oh, I see. How lovely. Hello, Ellie. Watch out! This isn't good. Oh, Pocoyo, Ellie didn't mean to crush your flower. And now she's stuck in your trap. Lula! It looks like more seeds! Can any of you tell Pocoyo
What will grow from all the seeds?
That's right! Lots and lots of flowers! Enough for everyone!
Hooray!
Hooray for Pocoyo! Oh, and of course, hooray for friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Lula! Oh dear, you're getting very dirty. You know what happens when you get dirty, don't you?
Bath.
That's right. It's time for a bath. Come on, get in the bathtub, Lula. Oh no! Lula, come back! It's just a bath. It won't hurt you. Ah, Ellie. Thank you. What's that, Pocoyo?
Soap.
Soap. Wonderful. And what's that, Ellie? A brush. Great. Very soon, Lula will be nice and clean.
Surfing the net with Ellie.
Hi, Ellie.
Ellie. Search, Ellie.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Clean.
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 Pocoyo wants to see something clean. Ah, it's Fred. Oh my. Are Fred's teeth clean?
No, they're dirty.
Clean, 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 clean. Clean.
I think we'd all like to see Fred clean those teeth. Ah, much better. It feels great to have clean teeth.
Thank you, Ellie.
Yes, thank you, Ellie. Well done. There. Lula is nice and clean. Uh-oh. Oh, dear. Here we go again. Can you tell Pocoyo what Ellie wants?
The soap, the brush, the soap and the brush. Soap, brush.
Shape shuffle. A square.
Square.
A circle.
Circle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
Square, circle, rectangle. Ooh, what's this, Pocoyo?
MP3.
An MP3 music player. And you've made it with circles, squares, and rectangles. Oh, a speaker. Can you tell me the names of the shapes?
Rectangles.
And these?
Squares.
And these?
Circles.
Square, circle, rectangle. Now Lula is really clean. Doesn't that feel nice, Lula? Uh-oh. This doesn't look good. Ah, good work. But it looks like someone else is dirty now. Yes, you, Pocoyo. Pocoyo, it's just a bath. It won't hurt you.
What is it? I wonder who it could be. Can any of you help me? Who is that singing?
It's Pato!
Pato! So it was you. I had no idea you could sing like that. There you are. There's nothing Pato loves more than getting clean. How many showers is that today for you, Pato? Three? Oh, I'm sorry. Four, of course. You'd better get going, though. Pocoyo and Ellie are waiting for you. Yes, indeed. Being clean certainly makes Pato happy. Pato! Pato! Look out for that! Phew! That was a close one. I think Ellie and Pocoyo are having lunch. I wonder what they're having. Don't you want a sandwich, Pato? Pato? Oh, I see. Too messy, is it? Pato, why don't you come out now? I'm sure Pocoyo and Ellie have finished eating now. Yes, they're bound to be playing something else by now. Now, where can they be? Finger painting, getting messy and having fun. Oh, dear. Yes. It's all right, you two. It's just that I don't think poor Pato wants to finger paint either.
You see, he just took a shower. What is it, Ellie? 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 Pocoyo? You know, Pato, you needn't be so worried about getting dirty. Yes, I know you're clean, but Pocoyo and Ellie have finished painting. I wonder what they're playing now. It can't be anything as messy as painting, can it?
Mopoy!
Oh dear! Well, that was amazing, Pato. Not a spot of mud on you. Wait a minute. Well, Pato was trying so hard to keep clean, but can any of you tell him what's happened?
He's dirty!
Yes, I'm afraid to say, Pato, you've got a spot of mud on you. Look. Pato? 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 You know, I was trying to tell you before, getting dirty isn't such a bad thing. No, it's true. Think of it this way. You like getting clean, don't you? Well, how much fun would it be to get clean if you didn't get just a little bit dirty first? Oh, look, how nice. Your friends even brought you a bathtub. I suppose Pato worked out that if getting a little dirty makes bath time a little more fun, then getting a lot dirty will make it a lot more fun. Hooray for getting dirty and for getting clean. Hooray for Pato. Hooray for Pocoyo. See you in the tub later. Bye-bye.